Today on Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV, we're in Shell Beach, Louisiana, in St. Bernard Parish with Captain Jakamo of Jakamo South Charters in Kerri, Callais. And we are going to go catch some speckled trout, and we're not going to go for a far boat ride. You want to go catch fish in the wintertime in Shell Beach, Louisiana, and burn less than a gallon of gas? Well, stay with us, and we're going to show you where to do it today on Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV.
Captioning is brought to you by Busby Modular Tackle Storage. Customizable internal bins allow you to personalize your tackle box, featuring a waterproof and airtight gasket which makes it float. Secured with stainless steel hinges and latches, industrial strength materials ensure this box is built to last. Get yours today at busby.com.
Well, there's nothing better than getting a good night's sleep before you go fishing, and we certainly did that in Captain Jakamo's brand new lodge called the Shell Pad. What an awesome place to stay. All we did, wake up in the morning, go across the street, get in the boat shed, and go down Bayou Wyklowski, cross the MRGO, and less than a mile away is Fort Beauregard, our Fort Proctor, and we stopped right there at the mouth of Lake Bourne, and that's as far as we needed to go today, and we start catching speckled trout. Jakamo with one.
See what happens.
So Jakamo, what'd you do? You put on my swim bait?
I did. The one that you said you never catch fish on?
The one I said I never catch fish on?
pretty good.
You see how nice that bait looks?
Beautiful.
I got it back in 96.
Mwah, love it.
Wee. Hey, can I have my pole back, Jack?
Ah, man, it's being used at the moment.
All right, gang, well, you know what? We're just starting to fish right now. But let's talk a little bit about what we've got here in St. Bernard Parish. We are literally in February, okay? And we are less than 3 minutes from the dock. I mean, this is no secret spot. We're at the fort. Campo's Marina is right over there. Mm-hmm.
That's old Campo's Marina right there.
Yeah, the old Campo's
the
Marina.
The old
one was right there.
Mm-hmm.
Kerri, you can come out here. We always talk about it, bringing the family and everything. Even this time of year, you don't have to make a boat ride. We got on a plane for 2 seconds.
This is off season, right? This is right. When people don't think you can come down here and fish, but it's 12 months a year down here.
12 months a year, and we literally, you could come fish this in a kayak. People come in this area. Mm-hmm. This is a place where a lot of people fish on this flat. You can fish in a kayak. And Jock, what do we have? We have some rocks here, and we have a flat. So I guess you got this fallen tide. Mm-hmm. And this eddy in here where the water's not moving as much, I guess, mm-hmm. and that's where those fish are ambushing.
Yeah, and we also, you know, we got lucky because we have a warming trend for the last few days, so that helps out quite a bit. Yeah. You know, that water temperature is like 59 degrees this morning instead of 54.
Yeah, you know, and one of the things that I've learned over the years in fishing with some guys, especially this time of year, even though the water temperature's warmed up some, you would think a popping cork mm-hmm. would be very effective because you're popping that bait and the fish don't have to go far to get it. The opposite side of that is that the fish aren't gonna move much. So that's what you're thinking. So if the fish aren't gonna move much and you're throwing a popping cork, that popping cork's sitting in one spot.
Right.
That cast and retrieve, you have a much better chance of running that bait right mm-hmm. in front of that fish and he's gonna strike it.
Yeah.
So there's two ways you can look at it, but if the popping cork works, it's working for a reason because it's sitting there still. But if that doesn't work, cast and retrieve and just run that bait by as many fish as you can, because mm-hmm. when you're doing that, you have a chance to run by your bait by many more fish than just popping a cork.
Absolutely, it's a covering ground.
That's all it is.
It's just, you know, you're moving a bait around a lot more.
And it's February, so it's always good. Start with a cork, have somebody else throw a jig, mm-hmm. and Let's see if we can catch another one.
See what happens.
I know.
I'm game.
All right.
There
got
she
one.
Goes.
Jerry's got one.
Yeah. Fish on.
Casting and retrieving. Matrix Vortex Shad. Nice.
Solid.
Solid for this time of year.
Oh, you got this, Kerri.
I got it.
The other thing that we can tell you that's very, very important here when we're doing this today is we have clean water. We're fishing with artificial baits. And when we're doing that, you've got a fluorocarbon leader. Make sure you have a fluorocarbon leader. That is very, very important. It'll make all the difference in the world of catching and not catching.
There we go, there we go.
Kerri with one.
Oh, yeah, that's a good one.
Good one, Kerri. Get him, I'll even get him off for you.
Oh, look at you.
I know.
A gentleman. You got that on tape right there.
You got that on tape. Oh, we called that. Yeah. Haven't been divorced twice. I can have two people that can attest that I'm probably not. All right, there you go. Nice speckled trout. There's the bait. 1/4 ounce deck grip jig head and vortex shad. Love that color. Pretty trout. Kerri's killing them. We're having a great time. Captain Jakamo made the call. We're going to stay in close today. He kind of thought about going out to the outside. Some of his buddies are out there right now. They're all going to be going to the dentist probably when they get done because of this wind. But we're sitting here less than 600 yards from Campo's Marina, catching fish. Haven't moved. Look behind us. I mean, come on. Catching fish.
Ba-bum. See if this one makes the cut, but it's a bite in February.
Jack, you know what, buddy?
Hey.
It doesn't, a fish is a fish. People just like to catch them.
There's no doubt. It beats sitting at the house. That's what I used to say.
He's sitting at the house. And the great thing about this time of year, you're not going to get a hard head.
Now we will.
How many times can he jinx us today?
I know, right? He started off the morning like that.
There we go.
Uh-oh.
Coming to the top of the water. Dodging the rain. You know, there was not supposed to be much rain today, but it's raining. Look how pretty. Now, pretty water. See how pretty that water is? And these trout are just coming up and knocking it. Another good February eater fish. Now, we ain't gonna catch 6-pounders today, guys. It ain't gonna happen. But we're gonna catch a bunch of 13-inchers. Oh, there's one. There we go, right here. There's one, right on the point. Well, we caught a bunch of fish a minute ago, and we caught them up, and then they just quit biting all of a sudden, so we started drifting, and that's what you have to do this time of year. This is not the time of year where you're just gonna go out and normally sit on a spot and catch 50 fish. You're gonna have to move, drift, use the trolling motor, but hey, can't beat it. You know, Kerri, the great thing about coming down here is, you know, we're going to show you Jakamo's camp. They can cook for you. It is an awesome camp, and we're getting a lot of new lodges down here. Mm-hmm. People are rebuilding, so there's some great lodges people that can come fish at. And then we had a meeting last night, and we ate at the kitchen table, which is just absolutely outstanding. They've got a deck out there, super food. So many options. I mean, we talk about the fishing, but the options for everything else are limitless.
Absolutely. They have live music there. There's lots of, you know, new places coming up in St. Bernard where you can come hang out, have dinner, you know, the night before. Come down here, stay at, you know, Jakamo or one of the guides down here's camps. And, you know, take the family, take a group of girls, take a, you know, a group of friends down here and have a charter captain take you out the next day. You know, you don't have to have a ton of knowledge or skill, you know, you can come down here, our charter captains take care of you, and you can have a fun day on the water and, you know, hang out and spend the weekend and, you know, be back home Sunday morning.
You know, and one of the things that's happened out here is that a lot of our charter captains in the summertime, especially here, are booked solid with corporate trips. There's a lot of corporate people. Well, obviously with COVID, the corporate people aren't traveling, so it's families that are driving. And you can drive down here, it's safe, you can go see what you can see in New Orleans, see all the sites in St. Bernard, but this is a family event. And you know, most of the time, we've always promoted this. It's always been a family event, but it's kind of always been corporate stuff and people. But
sure,
we're trying to get families now that are looking for something to do this spring and summer. This is something you can bring the family and do.
Absolutely. I mean, there's not a lot of options right now in travel. You know, this is something where you can drive out here, spend the weekend. You know, you don't have to worry about, you know, all the regulations and, you know, your social distance as it gets out here, right? So this is a great option for people looking for something to do that can't do the normal trips that they're usually going on. You know, we hope they come down here and enjoy, you know, some nature and some outdoors that, you know, maybe they're not normally doing. And it's a great way to spend a weekend.
Hey guys, Captain Jakamo here with Jakamo South Guide Service. We're in the brand new lodge that myself and Captain Jonathan Sanchez built last year, calling it the Shell Pad. We have four suites. Each suite has its own private bathroom, full bathroom, sleeps 24 people, 12 people comfortably on full bottom bunks. We offer catering. We offer, you know, lodging services, not just to our clients, but also to other people that want to come down in their own boats and stuff like that and fish for the weekend or other kind of parties and I guess like corporate team building events and things like that. So Mr. Glenn, Jonathan's daddy, is actually doing the catering service for us right now. So the food is always delicious. So give us a shot, 504-303-1494. Or go to the website, jakamosouth.com, and hopefully we see you down here in gorgeous St. Bernard.
Oh, there's one.
Uh-oh.
That one, I bounced off the bottom.
Slowed it down.
I slowed it down, it bounced off the bottom, speckled her out on the rocks. So we've caught them out in the middle on this flat, and we've caught them very much kind of doing different things, but this vortex shad has worked. That's a little bit on the small side, so we're going to turn him loose. Yeah, he's a little small, we'll turn him loose. But you know, as we fish here, it's kind of funny, there's so many things to do in St. Bernard Parish and there's so much history, and Kerri, we are basically fishing in front of history.
Absolutely.
Tell us what we're fishing in front of here.
This is the this is Fort Beauregard, right? You know, you can see Campo's Marina if you look, you know, just a little ways that way. You know, it's pretty amazing to have, you know, beautiful sites like this that, you know, are part of, you know, our culture and part of, you know, what made St. Bernard and New Orleans what it is today, and we get to stand right here in front of it and fish.
Fort Beauregard, also known as Fort Proctor, was built back in the 1850s adjacent to a railroad port called Proctorville. And it was surrounded by land at the time, if you can believe that. And it was intended to be a part of a fortification project protecting water routes to New Orleans. But due to delays by hurricanes and the Civil War, the fort was never garrisoned. And then in the 60s, when they built the Mississippi River Gulf Outlet, it was cut off from land access, and you could only get there now by boat. And historians note this place for its unusual design in two regards, because of its living quarters with bathrooms and extensive use of structural iron in construction. And as you can see, they must have done a pretty good job constructing this place, because it's been through a lot of different weather scenarios, and it's still standing right here in St. Bernard Parish.
Oh, Jakamo, getting Jack. Nice.
He stays on.
Oh, I got one too.
Oh, Kerri got one too. Double.
Don't ruin it.
Got
there
him.
There we go. Oh, and he come loose. Kerri
got it. One.
Come
Get
on
in.
With it.
Yes.
That's a double.
But what we're doing here is typical. You know, we got on those fish, actually, that was kind of a fast bite for this time of year, Jakamo. You know, earlier, because in February, oh, I got one too. When they start biting fast like this, it's kind of a different thing. You're normally not catching them one after the other, but this is three in a row. Look at this. I guess somebody's got the trophy of the day if he can keep his fish on. Oh! Nice. So I was about to make a point, which makes no sense now, because I was going to say normally this time of year you're catching two or three fish, not every cast, and here we are every cast catching a fish. I'm going to try to catch another one.
I'm calling that a triple, dude. I'm sorry. I'm just calling it a triple.
Jakamo with another one.
Oh, let's see if I can land it. A bomb.
You got him. Nice job, buddy. You know what I think you're going to be doing?
Cleaning fish.
Well, besides cleaning fish, I think you are going to make a trip to the tackle store. I think you're going to be making a trip and saying...
Well, I think you need to, because you're running a little light on these in your box now.
Purple and gold.
Purple and gold's out. These are out. So I swear,
I was cutting that thing off, and I said, you know what? I'm going to leave it on.
Mm-hmm. I'm glad you did.
Oh, come on up, bud. I'm about to take my... You want to trade rods?
I don't.
Do you want to trade rods?
I don't.
Now, Kerri, how unfair is this, okay? The fact that... Isn't he supposed to provide the rods and the bait for me?
Stole your rod.
Typically.
Stole my rod.
Catching your fish.
Typically.
Stole my rod. Is telling me now that I'm missing soft plastic baits out of my... I'm missing soft plastic
they
baits
are.
Out of my
They're
tackle.
Out.
They're gone. Which we haven't used.
Mm-hmm. But they're not there. I mean,
well,
I think.
I'm going to tell you, when we get back to your camp and you go to cook something, you're going to be like, damn, I thought I had some pots and pans and silverware
right?
in this place.
Wait,
I could have swore I had a big screen TV.
Happens quick.
Yeah. Don't you have to go to the store when you get back? I'll watch the camp.
LOA TV is brought to you by the Chandelier Islander Fishing Lodge, full service, all-inclusive meals and lodging in the heart of the Chandelier Islands. Come stay and play in paradise. How the Pros Do It is brought to you by the Louisiana Charter Boat Association. Visit lasaltwater.com.
All right, let's just talk about the baits that we fish with today. Really, really simple. Basically fishing with a quarter ounce death grip jig head. And the main color is this Vortex Shad from Matrix Shad. I think it's called Purple Haze. And then we've got the Shrimp Creole right here. Now, we were talking about that swim bait that we were so successful with, the one that I hardly ever used. And it's just a simple old Tsunami swim bait. You just buy them in this four pack like this. And that's the one that Jakamo caught a lot of fish on. And there is your quarter ounce death grip jig head. And basically, that's what we've done fishing today. Those simple baits have caught all the fish for us today. Busby Tackle System. Look, you know, we've got the big boxes now, but they also have come out with these smaller boxes as well. So if you're looking for a smaller tackle system, they've got those. Obviously these bins, you can take them out. They're replaceable. You can turn them different directions. You can make them all big like this, whatever you want to do. And this thing is completely waterproof and it is awesome. And I just keep a few jigs in them, but that's how we caught our fish today. Really, really simple, and the best thing is, we were just less than a mile from Campo's Marina. There he is.
There we go.
I felt that one. Bouncing it off the bottom now. So we're kind of changing some techniques and doing some different things. I decided to bounce off the bottom, and there we go. So just a little quick move and a little change of techniques. Jock's got us in a spot here now that we're kind of fishing out, but all of this area has got so much shell and everything on the bottom that there's fish here. Kerri, how much more fun can you have on a morning like this? You look at this, most people are like, God, who would want to go fishing in this? It's foggy, it's muggy, there's rain around,
you
and all we're
know.
Doing is catching fish.
Wow, what a trip today with Captain Jakamo of Jakamo South Charters, just minutes from his camp. We go out in February and catch a bunch of speckled trout. Doesn't get much better than that. Thank you, Captain Jakamo. And man, you have an awesome lodge in the shell pad. And if you want to come down and stay in a great place, I recommend chartering with Captain Jakamo and staying at the shell pad. Thank you, Kerri Callais, St. Bernard Parish Councilperson at Large, for joining us and helping us put some fish in the boat. And thanks to all of you for watching the show. And if you want to learn more about St. Bernard Parish, go to visitstbernard.com. For producer Jim Caesar, I'm Kevin Ford. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next week right here on Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV.